We recently spoke with a driver in California who may have contracted COVID-19 and has now been placed in 14-day quarantine. And Uber has said that they would compensate drivers like this. So are those drivers actually getting paid? The driver that we spoke with that may have contracted the illness was driving beginning of March, driving like normal, picking up Uber pool passengers and trying to get to their Quest bonus. And this driver was being proactive, like many drivers are doing now, offering passengers hand sanitizer, spraying disinfectant before and after passengers get into their vehicle. Then one day, this driver picked up a passenger in a pool ride, and the passenger relayed to the driver saying that they were recently in Taiwan and they had contracted the illness, and it was the sickest they had ever been. The conversation kind of grinded to a halt after that. After the passenger was dropped off, the driver disinfected the back seat, disinfected the handles. But I don't know how many of you have heard from your passengers that they've contracted the illness. If it was me personally as a driver, it would have probably scared the hell out of me and probably would have wanted me to stop driving for the rest of the day. But as this is that driver's full-time job, they continued to drive throughout the rest of the week. Then later that week, the driver picked up another passenger. The passenger needed a ride to the hospital and was very sick. The passenger said he needed to go to the Chinese hospital because he thinks he may have contracted the illness. So this was the first week in March. This driver gave rides to two passengers who may have contracted the illness and probably worried this driver. This driver was also being proactive, offering passengers sanitizer, disinfecting. So then the following week, this driver actually came down with a major cough. So as a full-time Uber driver, he had a major decision. The CDC and Uber are both saying that if you feel sick at all, you should self-isolate. And drivers especially, some of us come into contact with 20 plus people per day and we're confined inside this small vehicle, you know, 3-4 feet apart. So this driver made the right decision. He decided to stay home, and while he was home, his cough just kept getting worse and worse. Started feeling more miserable. His cough got so bad that he got to the point where he was feeling breathless, which is exactly what is being explained how this illness affects people. And this driver also contacted Uber and made them aware that he might have possibly contracted the illness. And Uber responded with one of their canned responses. We've all seen them many times before, and his account actually was not suspended. So conceivably, he could have still been driving even after telling Uber that he may have contracted the illness. But this driver continued to stay at home. His symptoms were getting worse. So this driver contacted his doctor, told him his symptoms. The doctor requested that he come in and get tested. I've heard about these tests too. What they do is they swab the back of your throat. I've heard it's really uncomfortable. And they also go through your nose and swab the back of your nasal cavity. And after that, this driver did get a note that to say that they should go into 14-day self-quarantine. And here's a look at the note he was given. And this is exactly what Uber asks for when you're trying to submit for 14 days of the compensation that they offer. All right, and quickly, in order to qualify for the 14 days of financial assistance from Uber, you qualify if any of the following happen. You are diagnosed with the illness, you are placed in an individual quarantine by a public health authority like this driver was, you are personally asked by a public health authority or licensed medical provider to self-isolate due to your risk of spreading the illness, or if your account is restricted by Uber as a result of information provided by a public health authority that you have been diagnosed or have been exposed to someone diagnosed with the illness. And additionally, you must have taken at least one trip on the Uber platform in the 30 days before March 6th of 2020. All right, so this driver met one of the requirements. So after they left the doctor's office, they went home and they applied for the 14 days of financial assistance. And here's a look at the website that you'll go to if this does happen to you, and we'll leave this link in the description. So after the driver submitted all the documents, then there was the waiting game, and Uber's response is typically 2 to 5 days. And as far as how the 14 days of financial assistance are calculated, you will get paid an average of the daily earnings over your last 6 months driving for Uber. So for instance, if a driver made $28.57 per day, they would get paid $400 for the 14-day financial assistance period. So after a few days, that driver actually did get the money deposited to their account. This driver in particular typically drives 60 to 70 hour weeks, so they actually received a 14-day financial assistance package of over $2,100. So this driver did get paid, which is a really good thing. It's good to see that Uber is stepping up and paying these drivers for lost wages. And real quickly, that driver was tested over 10 days ago and still has not received the test results from their tests, whether or not they tested positive for the illness. But this is a major problem throughout the entire United States right now. There are so many industries being affected right now. People are not getting paid. Good on Uber for offering this 14-day assistance program, but 14 days of compensation will not be enough long-term, especially if we can continue this shutdown for a month or months. Hopefully that's not the case, but what are we going to do if that does happen? But what do you guys think? Are you still driving? Should Uber even be operating right now? Our vehicles are these small like petri dishes of we're coming into contact with all these people every single day. The chances of us contracting the illness and spreading it is much higher than other people, especially people that are going to a desk job. But also, how many of you think you may have contracted the illness or have been diagnosed with the illness? And have you requested financial assistance from Uber? How has your experience gone? Leave a comment below and let us know. Again, we'll leave the link in the description for those drivers that think they may qualify for this 14 days of financial assistance from Uber. Thanks again for watching. Please like, comment, or subscribe, and stay healthy, guys. Thanks.